They never knew we would come. It Fulani never envisaged that the likes of Nnamdi Kanu will ever emerge. They never, never in a million years. They thought that he can bribe anybody. He can buy anybody. Offer him a jet, give him money, tell him, promise him good life with his family. Anywhere he wants. Promise him a house, mansion, oil well, anything he wants. Give him his money. After all, you can buy any woman, you can buy them. They are very weak. You can buy all of them. They never knew who we were. That I come from a line, I wouldn't call it royal, a line of nobility, where you have noble men that do not sell their conscience. If you knew my father, you would testify to what I'm telling you. Ask those that knew him, they will tell you who he is. Noble people, they do not compromise. Never. And then we came, or should I say, Chukwuka Kabiama determined that we should come at this time to save you. Not just to save Igbo people, not just to save Ibibio, not to save Efik alone, not to save Ejo, not to save Isoko, Urobo, Ishekiri, Igodomigodo. No, 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 not at all. But to set free everybody trapped in the colonial enclave called Nigeria. Because as I told you 2 days ago, those ruling Nigeria now are not Nigerians. If I thought there's anything like, let us assume there is something called Nigeria that Britain created. The people in charge now are not Nigerians. They are not indigenous to the land. They do not have a home. They have no home address. If you ask them, where is your home address? They don't have. They are nomads. If you don't know the meaning of nomad or nomadic life, go and Google it or look for your dictionary. That was why Jonathan set up nomadic education. Nomads means people that wander, wandering people. They don't stay in one place. They keep moving all over the place. Abraham in the Bible, that begot all of us, was a nomad. Until at a time, Elohim said to him, you should stop moving about all over the place. You have to stay in one place. But these people are still one of the few primitive tribes in the world moving their livestock from one place to another. So anywhere that comes is home. I want ethnic nationalities in Nigeria to understand the mess they are in. Some of you have no idea the type of the state of hopelessness you're in. I am here to remind you of it. And you may not act upon it, but try to tell your children what you've heard on Radio Biafra. So in the future, as their mother is being raped or their sister abducted, they'll say, oh, daddy, remember that thing you told us you heard on Radio Biafra? That is why we preach this gospel the way we do. They came from Sierra Leone, from Mali, from Senegal, from Chad, because Fulani in Nigeria hasn't got the numbers to fight. The reason why Southerners have not been attacked in the north, allow me to repeat, the only reason why Southerners have not been attacked in the north is because Hausa poor, Hausa peasants, that the Fulanis have ground into the dust. If you want to see poverty, go to Kanu. Go to Kanu State. You see what is poverty. This same downtrodden, because Fulani is a specialist in using people. They love to use people. These same people, they have traumatized their fathers, their grandfathers, every of their lineage going back 6 generations or more. The Hausas have just realized, courtesy of Radio Biafra, that we are no longer going to go out to kill Igbo people. We cannot do it for you anymore. And the Fulanis do not have the numbers to do so. Do you know how they managed to stop tomatoes and onions from coming down these past few days? Because anywhere you have any institution, you have Fulani in it, they always aspire to be at the head, to be giving orders and command. So they set up checkpoints where the commander of the that very detachment is a Fulani person. That's how they're ruling you. If all of us open our eyes tomorrow to say enough is enough, Fulani will be sent packing. I'm not asking for them to be attacked or for anybody to, but they cannot be in our forest, though. Makadia Mama, they cannot be in our, no, 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 God forbid, Batten. Let heaven fall, they cannot be in our forest. If we find them there, they are gone. And of course, some of them can testify to the goodness of the Lord in that regard. If you find you in any forest in the east, you are a goner. As I'm speaking, record what I'm telling you, record it, tape it down, and send to anybody you feel like sending it to. Our people must understand something. Those killing you are from Senegal, they are from Mali, they are from Niger, they are from Sierra Leone, they are from Chad. They came to rig elections. All of you were there when 7 year olds were voting in Kanu. You were there, you saw it. All of you saw it. People say, oh, but why do you speak this way about black? I say, because black people are useless. They never act on that thing that is right. Never. Morally speaking, black people are bankrupt morally. Moral bankruptcy. All of you, including your INEC, including observers from Europe, all of you came down during the elections of, was it 2015? You saw kids voting in Kanu State. You came again in 2019? You saw people, little children voting from Niger Republic. Didn't you see them? What did you do? You said, although there was rigging, we voted for them. APC won landslide again. They gave money to newspapers. You see, in Africa, every layer of life, or should I say existence, from your doctors to your lawyers, some of them, to your, or let's say legal practitioners, we bring it down to those holding high public offices and those serving beneath them. Have you seen the level of wickedness? Do you know that a doctor who took an oath, according to medical ethics, if you see somebody dying, is an emergency, you must treat that very person before asking for money. As long as you have the necessary materials or tools to treat that person, you must treat them. That is medical ethic. Go, I think it's medicine 101. Go to anywhere and the number one thing is to save life. But do you know that a doctor will know that somebody is... I'm digressing a bit because I want to tell you about the depth of what I call moral bankruptcy in the makeup, in the DNA of black people, why we are in the mess we are in today, and why the Fulanis are ruling all of us. Visit us. A doctor will tell you to go and bring deposit. If you don't bring deposit, that somebody will die. You think it's a joke? He'll be there. He'll be looking at somebody dying. You know, when I look at doctors in Nigeria, I know that, when I say people flinch, they say, hey, don't say, I know that the devil must be a black man. See, Satan must be from Africa somewhere. Lucifer. Do you know why I say that? You see a doctor watching somebody die, a pregnant woman that requires cesarean section or operation to bring out the baby. A doctor will tell the family, go and sell your land, I don't care. And the doctor will be watching and the woman will stop breathing. She will die with the baby in her stomach. There is a type of wickedness in the heart of a black man that makes you wonder who actually made these people. After many years of considering the way we behave and the way we react, God Almighty formed IPOB and said, you cannot reason like those people. For me to love you, for you people to have the freedom that I promised you, your job is not to set yourself free. Your job is to liberate the thinking capacity of an average black person all over the world. That is your job. That is the duty of Biafra. That is why I have sent you to come. That is the reason why somebody. I don't know if they have stopped. I don't know if they have stopped. You know, I think we are back again. I think they stopped me very briefly there, broadcasting on my... That's what they keep doing. Try to stop us from doing what Elohim have asked us to do. but have failed and will continue to fail. Fulani came into our land because of that same thing in a black man. When you see evil happening, you keep quiet. Because the Fulanis came and took over the Hausa land. Hausa themselves helped them to take over other people's land. Because of that, when it came to Biafra, the only people that can defend all of you, I say without apologies, everybody, it doesn't matter who you are, without Biafra, you are gone. Without Biafra, you are finished. Fulani will take your land from you and kill you in the process. You know what they did? They ganged up against Biafra. They ganged up against anybody trying to speak the truth. They killed the Legiwa. An honest man, the only journalist I know in the history of Nigeria, the only journalist I've ever known is Delegiwa. The rest are all rubbish. You can buy, after a while, you buy them over, all of them are all rubbish. Pure bunkum rubbish. Village idiots. Delegiwa stood on the path of the truth. Babangida killed Delegiwa, everybody knows this. That Babangida today is an elder statesman. People defer to his opinion, but he's a murderer, he is a killer. You know that Babangida is a killer. You know that very well. He killed Delegiwa because Delegiwa was exposing all the things they were doing, all the fraud with MPN and Fujro, all the things, all the evil things. Even Julius Berger, nobody will respect that man. He's in heaven, of course. They killed him. Delegiwa was fighting for a better life for everybody in Nigeria. They killed him. Nigerians did nothing. Nothing. That is part of that punishment that you're suffering now at the hands of these murderers from the Sahel. Do you think that God will forget? People, don't, you know, they go to all these churches and they sing, they jump up and down. They don't even actually understand who God is or how God operates. They have no idea. Isn't it very funny? The more churches you build, the more mosques you build, the more difficult things become. Have you not noticed it? The more churches you have, claiming you have miracle centers, the more difficult things become for you. Because you are in a period of perdition. I told you in 2015 that Somalia will be better than Nigeria. I am telling you, if you have not applied for your Somalian visa, go and apply for it now. If you have not applied for your visa to Somalia, because Somalia is hello, but it's better than, it's going to be way better than the zoo. Because when you people see evil, you condone it. And that evil has come to you. Now you are about to, you are going to discover. As they say, you are about to see something you have never seen before. They came down to our land. They came down to all the way from across the Sahel to rig election in a land that doesn't belong to them. Fulani owns no land in Nigeria. They own nothing. They are visitors. They are. And all of you are there. Just cowardly. They're afraid of them. Oh, don't say something. Oh, please don't say anything. If you say something, don't say something. All of them. I'm just looking at people and laughing at you. Typical cowardly, wretched black people. You cannot stand up against people. They don't even have the numbers. They don't have. All they are doing is that they are boasting in the media because they control it. They can give money to a useless Yoruba newspaper editor to publish junk and write for them. That's all they rely on. If you scratch the surface, you see that they are nothing. They don't have the numbers. They don't have the strength in depth. They don't have the know-how to defeat all of us once we are united. Impossible. It is impossible to defeat. Impossible.